हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर हेल्दी। आई अंजलि पटेल वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू माई क्लास एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर क्लास सिक्स। टुडे विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर फेजेज ऑफ अर्लीस्ट सोसाइटी वन। बिफोर कंटिन्यू आवर टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे विल डिस्कस द आंसर्स ऑफ होमवर्क क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैव गिवन यू इन आवर लास्ट क्लास। सो लेट्स डिस्कस द आंसर्स फर्स्ट। So students, let's start with our first homework question. And our first homework question was, the main tools used by early humans were made of stone. Why? So the answer is, the main tools used by early humans were made of stone because it was easily available. Stone was hard enough to be used as a weapon and could be sharpened into different sizes. Now the next homework question, and the next homework question was, why were early humans always traveled from one place to another in search of food, water and shelter? And the answer is, there were following reasons that early humans always traveled from one place to another. Hope you get the answer because we have discussed in our last class this topic. If they had stayed at one place for a long time, they would have consumed all the available plant and animal resources. So they travel from one place to another. The next reason, animal move from one place to another in search of food. Therefore, early humans had to follow their movement for food. The next one, plants and trees bear fruits in different seasons. Therefore, people migrated in search of different kinds of plants. So complete your answers and let's start with our topic. Students, as we have discussed in our previous class, that different phases of a Stone Age. Stone Age was divided into, classified into different phases. And it was divided according to quality of stone tools that early humans used. So the first first phase of a Stone Age was Paleolithic Age, which is also known as Old Stone Age. And the next one is Mesolithic Age, also known as Middle Stone Age. And the next one is Neolithic Age, also known as New Stone Age. So we'll start with Paleolithic Age. Paleolithic Age started from roughly, means not fixed that it is started from 2 million years ago. So it's approximately 2 million years ago and ended about 12,000 years ago. Archaeologists have found different types of stone tools during Paleolithic Age, such as scrapers. Scrapers is a type of tool used to remove something from the surface. So scrapers, choppers, clubs, bows, hand axes and arrows. Here I've mentioned photos also, which you can see the stone tools during Paleolithic Age. And students, Paleolithic Age divided into three periods, namely early Paleolithic, Middle Paleolithic and Late Paleolithic. Now the first period of Paleolithic Age, early Paleolithic, this period coincides. What is the meaning of coincides? Means exactly the same. This period was exactly the same with the first appearance of stone tools, means first feature of the stone tools. This period is also known as Ice Age. So early Paleolithic Age is also known as Ice Age because during this period the period was extremely cold and many parts of the earth was covered totally with ice. That's why this period is also called Ice Age. Simple tools such as hand axes and flakes were used during early Paleolithic period. Now the next one is Middle Paleolithic. During this period, early humans began to live in groups or tribes.
The main tools used were scrapers and bores. Late Paleolithic, this period coincides with last phase of Ice Age, means this period was similar with the last phase of Ice Age. The most common used tools of the late Paleolithic age was blades and burins. Burins, a type of tool, means a type of cutting tool which was used to cut something, with advanced arrows and fishing hooks which used to catch fish. Now the next one, type of Stone Age, or the next phase of Stone Age. The next phase of Stone Age is Mesolithic Age. This period was transition period, means the Mesolithic period was a period of change and began roughly around 12,000 years ago and ended about 10,000 years ago. Stone tools in this age were small, sharp, pointed and more efficient, means the tools were more developed than the huge and crude tools. Crude means the tools which were made in Paleolithic age was very big in size and was crude, kacche bhi the, but the tools of Mesolithic age, small, sharp, pointed and more efficient. So these type of more sharp and small pointed tools were called microliths. Now the next one phase of Stone Age is the Neolithic Age. This period began roughly around 10,000 years ago and ended about 4,000 years ago. Students, Neolithic age, during Neolithic age, the life of early humans changed completely, means now they were not only the hunter gatherers, they moved from one place to another and making stone tools for hunting only. They formed settled communities, means they settled to one place and started domesticating animals, and first time in the history they started domestication. In this period the tools were even sharper than the tools used in the Mesolithic age. They were polished to a sparkle, means this is evidence that they polished tools to sparkle. This is evidence that now the age is completely changed from the early phase of Paleolithic and Mesolithic age. Now the next one topic is sites. What is sites? Site is a place, a spot or center. Archaeologists have discovered evidence of hunter-gatherers, means which we have lot of evidences, proofs of hunters and gatherers from many places which archaeologists discovered and which give lot of information about the hunters and gatherers of early age. These evidences are in form of stone tools, pots, etc., which were made, used and left behind by early humans. These places known as sites. Now you can see the map. In this map various places are located, and here all the places which is marked with red triangles are sites from which archaeologists have found evidences of hunters and gatherers. You'll notice that many sites were located near rivers. Why? What was the reason that hunters and gatherers and the sites are, means availability of hunters and gatherers are near rivers only? Because of availability of water, and water is very important source for human beings for all their basic needs and for farming and for animals, humans, all. It is needed for and very important for their daily life. So many of the sites were located near rivers and lakes because humans generally settled across river or water sources. Now the next topic is how human made tools. So that time technology was not very advanced to make tools, but how then early humans started making tools are very important to know. people tried to find places where good quality stones were available, because stone tools were the main source, so they need stone for that. In the early days, humans searched such type of stones for making better tools. Later, they started making basic stone tools for specific needs. Flint. Flint is a type of a stone was widely used to make tools and weapons because it could be shaped easily. Early humans used both big and small stones to make tools and weapons. The bigger stones were used to make axe heads, choppers, hammers, means big tools, while small pieces of stones were used to make knives, scrapers. Also, smaller pieces of stones were given a sharp point and tied to arrow and spears, which were used to hunt animals, जिसको भाला कहते हैं, which used to hunt animals were made from stone, small stone. Now, early humans used the following methods of stone tools. First, stone on stone. In this method, stone to stone shape was used to strike by another stone till the first stone acquired the desired shape. मीन्स स्टोन पे स्टोन को रख के उसको तब तक स्ट्राइक करते थे जब तक कि वो शेप में ना जाए जैसा कि वो चाहते हैं. प्रेशर फ्लेकिंग. इन दिस मेथड द स्टोन टू बी चिप्ड वॉज प्लेस्ड ऑन अ फर्म सरफेस सच एज अ रफ रॉक, मीन्स जिसपे घिसते थे पत्थर को, विथ अ स्टोन शार्पेंड फ्रॉम वन एंड वॉज केप्ट ऑन द फर्स्ट स्टोन. Then another stone was struck hard and dull surface of the second for acquiring the desired shape. जिसको pressure flaking कहते हैं. Pressure से उसको flake किया जाता था ताकि जो भी desired shape हो उनकी उसमें वो stone आ जाए. Shattering technique. In this method, the maker holds the suitable stone with his hand, rises to a certain height and then releases the same as the stone breaks into pieces. When it hits the ground from such stone pieces and required size can be selected and trimmed further. So basically in shattering technique, the maker used to release the big stone from a certain height, and then when the big stone break down into pieces, when it hits the ground, the broken pieces or the small pieces of rocks or stone were collected and the required size was selected, or if needed it will be trimmed to use it as a tool or to grind or stone hammer was made. Now here we finished our topic.
So students, today's session is finished here. Hope you understood the topics properly. Read the chapter, do your homework questions. I have given your homework questions in PDF. Read the questions and find out the answers properly and write it down. Till then, stay safe and thank you.